You mean today, like this morning? Probably this conference would be one, right? The fact that there are thousands of people that care about media and community media and telling people's narratives, that's a censored story every day. Yeah, it really is. As far as the stuff that we've been researching, we're getting ready for our next book, Censored 2014, that unfortunately, we write this book every year. It's a different book. It would be great if we didn't have to write that book at all. Because we did have a people's press and a free press that functioned in the interest of the public and the people. Some of the stories we're looking at, you know, some of the stories we look at are historical in nature. I did research just this past year on the Kent State shootings that happened in 1970, and we're still unearthing material about it that the institutions at Kent, the governor, and the Ohio government, and the federal government don't want to see, don't want to look at. Just this past year, the Department of Justice refused to look at the new forensic evidence that suggested clearly that the Ohio National Guard was ordered to fire on unarmed protesters. In fact, we have forensic evidence from an independent expert that shows this through audio tapes. And Dennis Kucinich, when he was still in the Congress, petitioned the Department of Justice, and it took a year for the Holder's Justice Department to get back to Kucinich to say that they had no interest in opening the case. They have no interest in reopening the case, and they weren't going to open the case. And as far as they were concerned, it was case closed. And this May, on the 43rd anniversary of the Kent State shootings, we'll see what happens. Oliver Stone is actually a keynote speaker there, and maybe he will bring some of this untold history to the new visitor center there that is a memorial to murder, essentially, to try to cover that up. So there's these kinds of narratives that cover up these kind of wrongdoings happen daily.